So I'm cutting the bulk short. I'm cutting it short by about 6 months. I've been bulking roughly 5 months right now, and I was gonna do it until the end of this deployment in Korea, but I'm just gonna stop right now and transition to a cut. There's like two reasons. The first is cardio is really killing me. You know, being in the Army and being a platoon leader in an infantry platoon, I'm expected to lead the platoon in runs and be one of the best runners. And bulking and sitting at a weight this high is really making that hard. And I wanna end my time in the Army less than a year now with a strong perspective from the guys and on a high note, if you guys know what I'm talking about. And the second reason I'm transitioning into this cut is to build brand awareness for my company. So I want to really build some buzz and awareness and build a marketing profile for myself and the company, and building advertisements and being cut and shredded makes it that much easier. So I want to make the transition out of the Army and starting the gym and running this company full time as easy as possible. I think starting a cut now and establishing that online presence will be in the best terms for me and the business at this point. Now, cardio wise, all I'm doing is stuff we do at PT. So it's like cardio 3 times a week. The first is like a 4 to 5 mile run on Mondays. Wednesdays is a track cardio VO2 max improvement workout. And then on Fridays, we do a ruck march anywhere from like 4 to 12 miles. So that's the reasons I'm transitioning out of this bulk into a cut. And in this video, I'll go into details of really what I'm doing and how I'm structuring it. All right, so training wise, for this cut, I'm really not changing anything from when I was bulking and maintaining. My split's staying the same. I'm hitting everything twice a week, except for shoulders. Shoulders is once a week. And today's workout is a chest and back workout. Now, the difference between this workout and my other chest and back workouts, this is kind of the fine tune. So I'll have one day dedicated to back and biceps, one day dedicated to chest and triceps. And I see that as my course adjustment, where I'm putting the most work, the most volume in for those body parts. And then 2 days after I hit my chest workout, I have a back and chest workout, which is today, which is kind of my fine adjustment. So I'm still a little sore. I'm not breaking down the muscles as much. I'm not doing as much volume, but it's just a opportunity for me to get a little bit more volume in. So I'll hit about 3 exercises for chest and then 3 for back in the mid to higher rep ranges. I'm on lunch right now. I'm gonna train abs. I started training abs again 2 days ago. My abs are absolutely killing me. The only thing I've been doing for core lately is what we do at PT with the Army. So whether that's like a P90X ab workout, toes to bar, stuff like that, it doesn't get too in depth. But I'm gonna do the same training program I did for my contest prep in 2013. So I'll overlay clips right here of what I'm doing at the gym today. And it's what I'm gonna do 3 times a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Now typically I train in the mornings, and that's when I do all my resistance training in between PT and work, and I'm having trouble fitting in abs in as well. So for example, like today, and I'll probably do this in most cases, I'll go during lunch. It takes me like 15 to 20 minutes total to knock out the workout. It's 2 exercises, 8 sets total. The first exercise is hanging leg raises. So if your gym has like the slip ones that attach by a hook on a pull-up bar, I'll do 4 sets of that, 20 reps total. You just bring your feet from a hanging dead hang up until it touches your elbows or you touch the bar, and just a controlled movement, 20 reps total. Very simple. The next exercise is cable crunches. So you'll just use the cable attachment, the rope piece for that, and you'll use it at the top setting. As much weight as you can do. I do 4 sets total for this one too, around 15 to 20 reps. Like I said, I keep it simple, but it's very effective for me, and it's what I did last contest prep. Other than diet, and then training your core a little bit, your compound movements, abs will come out when you get lean enough, and that's what I found to be, you know, effective for me. All right, so right now it's like 5 p.m. Got a few more things to do at work before leaving home, so I've grabbed a snack really quick. So this is like a go-to, especially when I'm like dieting or cutting. It's just rice cake, some peanut butter, sometimes I'll throw like cinnamon, sugar-free chocolate syrup on there, and then sliced up banana. So I will cover what I'm changing nutrition-wise. I'm going into about a 500-calorie deficit right from the beginning. So I was around 3,900 calories at the peak of my bulk. It was 250 protein, 525 to 550 carbs, 90 grams of fat. And my macros now, my new macros, are 250 protein, 425 carbs, and 75 grams of fat. So I decreased carbs by about 100 and then fat by 15 grams. That's the initial change, and then I'll ride out those macros until I either need a change, I break a plateau, weight loss stops, I'm not seeing changes in the mirror. And that will be, you know, week to week, month to month basis. I'm not going to make a plan, a strategic plan of what I'm going to change my macros. It's just I make changes based off of how I feel and how I'm changing. But I actually feel better on these macros. When I was at like 550 grams of carbs, it was almost too many grams of carbs for me. I was feeling very full and uncomfortable the end of the night, almost like I was forcing myself to feed and eat. So 425 grams of carbs for me is more comfortable. If you guys follow me on Snapchat, you know I have like 5 boars that come out my apartment every night, and they make noise, they fight, they're huge. I tried filming it, but it's just too dark to see anything. But the end state of the cut, to kind of switch topics really quick. Now, to put a number on it, I will probably reach the low 200s. I'm sitting at 230 right now, which is the heaviest I've ever been. But I'm not putting like a timeline on this cut. So I'm gonna start my transition out of my bulk into my cut, into a deficit. I'll make changes as I go, and then I'll change my macros based off of the changes that I see. I'm not really using the scale. I'll use that as a judge for if I'm making progress in the short period of time. But in the long phases and overall long progress, I'll use the mirror in the gym to gauge my results. Now, one supplement I wanted to touch on, people ask me all the time how my supplementation changes from a bulk to a cut, and it really doesn't change at all. I mean, I keep taking creatine, I take pre-workout, I take a multivitamin, and then amino acids. Now, I wanted to touch on IntraFlight just for this reason, because when I formulated it, it was when me and my brother were dieting for our first show. So our last prep, I made this product to take just for that reason. Now, amino acids and IntraFlight has like a two-purpose punch. You know what I mean? Like IntraFlight with the amino acids and then the citrulline, agmatine, taurine, and carnitine L-tartrate, you get the energy, you get the endurance and the pump during your workout. You can use that if you're bulking, maintaining, or cutting. But then amino acids have been shown in studies to be very beneficial when in a deficit. And that's kind of why I formulated it this way. Now, when you're in a deficit, a caloric deficit, and the deeper you get into a prep, the more profound you'll see this kind of happening, is protein synthesis will decrease a little bit and protein breakdown will increase. And when protein breakdown is more than your protein synthesis, that is a loss of muscle, which is, you know, the main purpose of a cut is to lose as much fat but maintain as much muscle as possible. Now, in studies, what amino acids have been shown to do is actually increase your ability to synthesize protein and reduce the amount of protein breakdown that's going on. So supplementing, you know, with an amino acid supplement, doesn't have to be IntraFlight, but an amino acid supplement while in a deficit can be very beneficial to maintain as much muscle mass while you're burning that fat. Now, when I first start a cut or a deficit, I'm taking it just as I usually would just during my workout once a day. But the deeper I get into a cut, I'll increase the frequency of the times I consume amino acids. So it'll do, you know, 2 or 3 times a day, once during my workout and then in between meals to get that high leucine content in there. So that's how I kind of manipulate my supplements during a cut as opposed to a bulk. So that's the video, guys. Just a big introduction to this cut that I'm going to be doing for the next couple months. Hope you guys enjoy it. Welcome to the journey. I'll talk to you guys in the next video.